Thank you for joining us today. I'm Rudy Stebbe, and this is HelpDesk TV for Windows 7. In part one of this six-part series on backing up your computer, we are going to show you the best way to back up your personal data files. My New Year's resolution for 2012 was to find an online backup storage solution for the many gigabytes of personal data I currently have, and that would be cost-effective. My concern being the many gigabytes of photos, graphics, and music files I'm currently storing on my hard drive that are susceptible to data loss. In searching for this solution, I came across a product that offered several backup solutions ranging from free to very affordable. The backup solution I found comes from CrashPlan.com. As you can see, they have plans that start at free and range up to $120 per year for unlimited storage up to 10 personal computers. In this six-part video series, we'll show you how to set up a free backup solution as well as using CrashPlan as an off-site online storage solution. Note that if you decide not to continue with an online storage plan, your backups will revert to the free backup solution after 30 days. To get started, you will need to download the free trial software. You can download the free software by going to CrashPlan.com. Downloading the free software will also give you a 30-day free trial to the CrashPlan Plus, which includes 10 gigabytes of cloud-based storage. In part one of the series, we'll mostly concentrate on the installation of CrashPlan and setting up your initial trial account. The following videos will demonstrate how to back up your data locally and to the cloud for optimal protection. Now, hover your mouse over the Download Free Trial icon and select your operating system. Note, you can see CrashPlan is compatible with the Mac OS X operating system, as well as the Windows 32 and 64-bit, Linux, and OpenSolaris operating systems. This video will demonstrate the Windows version of CrashPlan, although the steps to install the software on other platforms is mostly identical. Now, click on the Download for Windows button. Choose to save as, and then save the file to your desktop. Once the file is downloaded, close your browser and locate the CrashPlan file that you just downloaded. And now double-click it to run it. Of course, choose Yes at the user account control if it pops up. Follow the installation setup to install CrashPlan on your computer. Read and accept the end user license agreement. And then choose an installation folder where CrashPlan will be installed to. And now finally, click Install. Once the installation is completed, click Finish. Now it's time to create your free CrashPlan account. Make sure New Account is selected and enter your new account info. Then click the Create Account button. This is mainly to start your 30-day free trial, as well as to send you alerts and reports on your backups. Once your account has been created, you will find yourself on the main CrashPlan backup screen. And now you are well on your way to securing your data from hard drive failures. By default, CrashPlan will back up your entire home user folder. You will see this in the right pane in the panel labeled Files. Your home user folder is now currently being scanned, and a total file count and data size is being calculated. At this time, no files are being backed up. Once the scanning has completed, though, you can click the Change button to select additional specific files and folders you wish to back up or not back up by unselecting the file or folder. These changes will be reflected in the Files panel once you click the Save button. Part 2 on our Backing Up Your Computer series will guide you through the steps to implement an automated backup solution of your personal data files to a local storage device. I hope you enjoyed today's Helpdesk TV. If you need further assistance in setting up CrashPlan as your backup solution, you can contact us on our support form here at forums.helpdesktv.ca.